Welcome to another week. There is a power outage in the whole block here apparently, maybe because of the construction on the streets. But I'm not really affected by that too much because I just finished packing up my bag and it's almost half empty, but I need this big suitcase for my skateboard. Yeah, now I'm gonna take the bus because I don't have internet, so I can't call an Uber, and this app that would allow me to do this offline seems to not work. All right, time to go on a fun trip. Again. So this video will probably be only about this weekend, where I will go to LA, or more specifically to Long Beach, California, to learn kiteboarding. Okay, I just missed the bus because apparently there is no bus station anymore where there used to be one. So this will again be closer than I would like it to be. I think I have about a half an hour of a buffer. All right, I am at the airport and not too late, I think. Because I ran to the university in about 10 minutes or so, where I had Wi-Fi again, and then I could call an Uber the normal way. Sorry, lighting. And now I still have, I think, an hour until the flight goes. Sorry, mom and dad. Yeah, I didn't really change growing up. In 3 days, I'm gonna have been here for exactly 1 year. So I thought I'm gonna give you and also my future self a little resume. So this airport is a nightmare to get away from. Cosmic love gave you something gold. Now I'm gonna take the metro and not the car in this city, but it'll cost me only $1.75 in total. And if I went with some ride sharing app or taxi or so, it would have cost more than $30. Yeah, it's a bit ironic to talk about Tucson when I'm currently in another city, but here we go. First, the weather. Yes, it is super hot, but it's also super dry, which makes it not hell at all. And I actually kind of like it. So last year in July, I saw in the German news that southern Arizona hit these record highs of in the 50s or so Celsius, of course. And this year I was waiting for it, and I was waiting, and it never really hit more than 45 or so. From my previous videos, you know that the only thing that I miss is a little bit of variety while I have to find my Airbnb house now. That Airbnb is awesome. For now, what are my thoughts on Tucson, Arizona? Well, to be honest, it's not my favorite city in the world. You know, the population density is just really low and feels like it's just a huge suburb. So the nickname of El Pueblo, the village, is no coincidence. And I really like the metropolitan flair of really big cities. I like skyscrapers and skylines and everything. And yeah, that is not really what you find in Tucson. But I really like the unique kind of charm that this city has, or town. Even though there's not that much going on, it's just, yeah, it's got a certain feel to it. Things you found, you feel a little younger, and you begin to wonder, what is it you want to love? What is Long Beach in comparison to that feels just, it's got these pretty beach houses everywhere, and yeah, it's just the typical California beach flair.
Walk around and get going.
Well, that was that. That didn't work out. So I wanted to like learn kite surfing here in this one whole day that I got in Long Beach, but we didn't have enough wind, so that's why we just went into the water and I body dragged for like a minute, and then the wind just wasn't enough. So now I'm really glad that I booked my flight back from LA to Tucson only 2 days after we arrive in LA, so that I can go here and again and learn it then, if there is going to be enough wind on that day. It's gonna be in 2 weeks. Yeah.
If I were a rich man, I'd probably also want to buy a house there.
Have I ever felt homesick? Well, yes. Twice or thrice maybe in this last year. But I realized that it wasn't so much the home that I was missing and more the free time that I had while I was still at home and, yeah, younger. So only when I had really absolutely no free time for more than 1 or 2 weeks or so, I would get nostalgic and think back to those times when I was just lying on the couch and seeing those dust particles fly in the air. Which kind of brings me to my next point. My next point being my work. I have the feeling that I was constantly whining about how little I got done and how much further I wanted to be. But looking back at that year, I think I can be proud of what I have accomplished so far. And it currently looks like that I have invested my time just in order to get so much more done in the future. Yeah, so still kind of happy with where I am.
What's left to do but to feel it all? You're alive now, to die is dust.
Yeah, that's pretty much the life to live. Before I started this PhD, I thought that, you know, you don't really earn that much money, but you get the benefit of traveling around the world on other people's expenses, and so that's a pretty good positive point. And now I can say yes, it's actually true. I mean, not only am I here halfway for free, but I also just yesterday got the acceptance letter for another workshop in Columbus, Ohio. Gotta go there as well in early September, so it's not that far away. Yeah, as I said, this is pretty much the life. It's currently 1:30, my flight will go in about 9 hours. Still enough time to hit up a museum. You got me stoned, and I like how it feels. When my heart beat on my chest, that's how I know that it's real. You got me high. That was really nice. I'm glad that I did that. Alright, get a shower, pack my bags, and then catch something to go to the airport. Still 5 hours left, but you know, it'll take me 2 hours by public transport, so I don't want to make it as close as the last flight that I still caught. My thoughts about the University of Arizona? Well, it's professional, friendly, you have a lot of opportunity to get involved. And there are lots of services on campus that you can use, like, you know, the supercomputer or 3D printing. And there's a lot done that students feel well. I'm still proud to be part of that. And especially now that, according to some rating, they are the 52nd, or we are on the 52nd place in the world, according to something. That was a weird kind of check-in process, but I liked it. It was pretty quick for me at least. Have I found friends here? Nah, people here kind of suck. Nah, for real though, I found about 3 somewhat close friends, and of course many more people that I am friends with, and I managed to stay in somewhat regular contact with my people at home. That's definitely a good thing to do, and maybe also necessary. Going through security, we didn't even have to put our shoes off or the laptops out of our bags. I think our safety is being jeopardized here. I can
I saw you like mad dashing out of the terminal to go to terminal 3.
As for my language, I think subjectively, well, just see for yourself.
I hope that I can make it a habit to weekly or monthly put out vlogs throughout the 5 years. So that would be really interesting to see how I develop, how my accent develops, and yeah, how I feel during my work.
Okay, stop!
I estimate about 30 to 40 minutes more to start our flight. Thank you for the attention.
How was your night?
That was alright. I watched
what?
The movies.
So our flight was delayed by 2 hours, but that does not really matter because we had a 7 hour layover here anyway, so now it's just 5 hours in Bogota, Colombia. And I'm really tired. Last thing I want to add to my kind of summary is that I feel much more adult now than I have been 1.5 years ago, and especially in a kind of social context, I think I became much more confident, as you may see, hopefully.
Excuse me, I have a random question. What? How do you say it?
Ooh, second stamp.
Yeah, Greg's in trouble.
Oh, uh-oh.
Yeah. How much did you have to slip through?
No, she just took a long time looking at all my pages. We can find it one way or another.
Yeah.
We'll put the luggage in because we put it on top of ourselves too.
I didn't get any significant difference, but the way that I was measuring the bivouac density was really crude.
Yeah. Oh, take care.
Okay.
Oh. Ooh.
That's fast.
From my angle, it looked like your hand got caught in there. Like,
no, I was fine. Mm-hmm.
Capacity, 6 people.
6? What? No, it's not.
Bijou, hace la próxima semana.